with their explosive report from Circa News. Sarah Carter, John Solomon. Thank you, John, especially for making a rare appearance. Sarah's been doing all the heavy lifting on the show.
She has indeed.
This is very important. Now, how is it that Evelyn Farkas, Sarah, who left the administration, is talking specifically about surveillance? It seems like she's admitting the surveillance that you've been reporting on and John's been reporting on, that took place of Trump transition team members. She's admitting that they unmasked them because they're Trump transition team members. And it seems like she's talking about, well, we got to get it to our friends that they're A, politicizing intelligence, and B, talking about leaking intelligence. What are your thoughts?
My thoughts are, you know, with the story that John and I broke today with regards to how the Obama administration loosened a lot of the regulations that protected the privacy of Americans. I mean, this was going back all the way to 2011. Remember, everyone thought for a long time, and once it was revealed that in January, when Obama expanded Executive Order 12333 to all the agencies, everybody was just focused on that. But nobody was focusing on what happened before that. And I think with what John and I were able to show is that, look, it didn't happen just in January. That expanded it even further into all 16 agencies. But in 2011, there was already the unraveling of what we consider our privacy rights. And then again in 2015, it happened again. So they were already set up to look at these unredacted, unmasked transcripts between Americans and foreign officials, or foreigner to foreigner, you know, that we're talking about Americans.
All right,
and
I think that's a huge revelation. Because I think this is important, John, I'll throw this to you, because Evelyn also served as an advisor to Hillary Clinton in the 2016 presidential campaign. According to one report, was up for a position if she had won. So she's out in 2015. We're talking about 2016 here. How would somebody that was once a rather low level official, with no offense to her, she's serving her country, how would she have known that there was surveillance of Trump and his transition team? If you break down, if they found out how we knew, what we knew about the Trump staff dealing with the Russians, wow, how would she possibly know that outside of government now?
Yeah, that's a really great question. And her appearance raises more questions than we have answers to right now. But it's possible the surveillance started earlier when she was a Russia expert inside the Pentagon in 2015. That's something we have to look at. It's
John, yep. What you just said, they could have been surveilling in 2015?
Certainly possible. Listen, we don't know, so I don't want to leap to any conclusions, but that's one possibility. Another possibility is someone passed this information along to her. It could be some of the information she has isn't classified at all, though she used the word intelligence, so that's a red flag, right? I think her appearance on that show is going to raise a lot of questions, and we may not know the answers to them for a little bit of time, but there's certainly some important questions that she's raised in that appearance.
Let me go through a quick bullet point list and ask if you both agree. Do you both agree she's admitting surveillance, at least of the Trump transition team and the president-elect, took place? She seems to confirm that. Do you both agree with that?
I'd say, listen, there are many different ways you can find out what's going on overseas. Surveillance is one of them. Wiretaps is one of them. Intercepts is one of them. Sometimes human intelligence is another one. A foreign government comes in and said, hey, we found this out about an American.
If they found out how we knew what we knew, that would compromise sources and methods.
Right.
That's
sources and methods could be humans, too. It doesn't necessarily mean surveillance or wiretaps. It could
be
one of many different ways.
And it's also
It may be all of those ways.
Right.
They may have utilized all of those ways.
Okay, so it seems to acknowledge surveillance took place. Had to. How else would she know this information? Some sort of surveillance, that's the only way that they'd get that. All right, she's also revealing when she talks about if they found out how we knew, what we knew about the Trump staff dealing with the Russians, doesn't that mean some unmasking took place of some kind, Sarah?
I think so. I mean, I think we already showed through our reporting that unmasking took place. And what we know for a fact is that with Flynn, and it's on the separate, you know, investigation, his name was leaked. So Lieutenant General Mike Flynn's name was leaked out there. So we know for a fact unmasking took place. But what unmasking was it? Who was unmasked? And who authorized the unmasking?
She's saying the Trump staff, what we knew about the Trump staff.
Yes, but who in the Trump
staff? How would they possibly know, unless somebody's leaking? Now, then she talks about, I knew it was important. I was urging my colleagues on the Hill to keep this information, gather this information. Who are these colleagues? Do they have security clearances? Should they have access to this information? that would be, if you leak any intelligence, even if it's to a member of Congress, wouldn't that still serve as a felony under the Espionage Act, John?
If it was transmitted through channels that were not authorized, absolutely there could be criminal conduct. If it wasn't classified, there may not be. There's just so many questions we don't know, but I will say that her appearance raised more questions, and I talked to some people on Capitol Hill late today that were telling us they have the same questions. They're going to start asking their colleagues, the Democrats on the Hill, were you taking information from this woman and her friends?
Is this possible? Now, we all can go back to Watergate. And by the way, number one, it proves Trump was right. There was surveillance. We now have confirmed through you guys, James Rosenier, Fox News, and I think this also backs us up. Trump was surveilled. He was right in his tweet that he sent out that day. If we go back to Watergate and we look at Watergate, wasn't that about a break-in, about a political opponent? Didn't that become a big scandal and a president resigned? My question to both of you, do you think based on where this story is now, this has the potential of being even bigger? If we're talking about surveillance, unmasking, leaking intelligence, even bigger than Watergate? Is that a possibility where this ends up? Sarah.
Yes, I do. I think so. I think it's something that needs to be investigated, and I think we need to look at what civil liberties here have been violated and how far this expansion, these regulations have been loosened to allow people. I mean, even in our story today, we talked about top Obama aides viewing unmasked intercepts on a routine basis. What were they viewing? Why were they viewing it? Why did they need to view these? Some may be legitimate, but if we find out that they were just viewing conversations between even then, you know, President Trump and other foreign officials and members of his team.
That's illegal if you don't have a warrant for President Trump, even if it was picked up incidentally. John, how big does this story potentially get?
You know, a couple weeks ago when Democrats were throwing Watergate around, I said the same thing on your show, which is, listen, Watergate had a lot of crimes in it. We're a long way from proving crimes yet, but I do think that there's
a
really...
Don't you think a crime committed with releasing the intelligence information on General Flynn, isn't that a felony?
We have a leak investigation, but Watergate was much larger than leaks, as you know. In fact, the one leak that made Watergate, a lot of people herald as a great moment. We're just a long way from there yet. But we need, listen, there are important issues that need to be answered here. And the story that we broke today, if you're a Republican, a Democrat, an independent, you should be really concerned how easy it is today that large numbers of members of the government, for a very low threshold, can ask the NSA, hey, if you intercepted John Solomon or Sean Hannity, could you unmask his name? Because we're trying to understand this intelligence. It used to be that was a very rare moment. When you look at the rules that Obama changed in 2011 and through 2017, it is very easy now for the intelligence community to get someone's American's name and see what they were intercepted.
We got to take a break. We'll